Yeah, so it's been a week since fight. Recovery's going good and I've pulled up pretty well. Should be having the stitches out maybe today. So injuries that I sustained from the fight was a gash across the eyebrow. I think I got 4 stitches across there. Just some marks across the face and that. So did this earlier in the training camp, a few weeks out from the actual fight. So I ruptured the ligament in my thumb. So we kept that under wraps and I just boxed through it. And so the training camp duration was, I think about 13, 12 weeks all up. I think maybe the first 4-5 weeks we were training at the home gym and that was just to build a base fitness. And then we headed over to America and stayed in Las Vegas for 5 weeks and done most of our technical and sparring and prep work there. And the back end of our training block was the last two and a half weeks over back at home here. And yeah, the last week pretty much just over in Perth and sealing the deal and getting the weight right and adjusting to the time zone and things like that. Every camp's just getting more and more intense. And that's one thing I've always found in boxing is like whenever anything gets easy, it doesn't get easier, it just gets harder because it's like, all right, well, if you're doing that quite well, let's go harder, let's push, let's find an extra 1%. Weight cut was obviously unknown territory for me, going down an extra weight class, and never done it before. I'd done it well, I believe. I was very methodical in my diet and, you know, not being stupid, not overcooking myself and starting to dehydrate myself too early. So it came down to it. We got the last bit off in what they call the weight cut. Hydration's a big factor. It's like who can rehydrate the best can literally turn the tables. My coach has been around the game for yonky donks. He knows what to do and things like that. And I'm working with a nutritionist that specializes in combat athletes. So, you know, I've just surrounded myself with the best in the business. And I really feel that when I'm making these weight cuts and I'm getting back in the ring and I feel huge and I feel ready to go. And you know, that my energy is not zapped and things like that. So, yeah. Come fight night, I was feeling really good. Trained a long time for this one and kind of just had like this date in my head and I was just excited. There was something in the air about that night that just seemed, oh, this is kind of monumental for me and my career. And I walked from my hotel around the corner over to the venue and I just felt really good. Then we ended up having a cracking fight and like, you know, the crowd got behind and it was the love that I feel from my city every time I go there. And you know, they showed out once again and I love to embrace that. We got out there and there wasn't a lot of footage on him. So yeah, from round 1 to 3 was quite competitive. And you know, he really kind of brought it in them rounds 2 and 3. And wasn't until round 4 I had to change my game plan a little bit to open up holes and kind of see what looks I could get from that instead of going forward so much. And you know, that managed to help me score a knockdown and that really swung the fight, I think.
4th round. You can see the good.
Oh, face down! Right in front of Al! Commentary position from the counter left hook! Yep. Gutierrez is hurt! He gets up slowly, Bill Set gives the count, he's on wobbly legs!
He's got to go for it.
Yeah, I mean, kind of, often he was a bit more wary of my power and my speed, so yeah. You know, from kind of round 4 up to round 9, it was like just pick up the rounds and see if we can kind of open him up a bit. But he was tough, to his credit. He was very, very strong and can wear a punch and give him back as well. So, mate, I felt like that was a really, really entertaining fight for any stage, really. So I'd take my hat off to him and it was boss. I loved every minute of it. And, you know, we embraced each other in the 10th round and gave each other hugs. And it's like, you know, just respect to say like, this was a good fight, mate. Like, thank you. And then we went out and I just sealed the deal with the 10th round and yeah, got the W. I had my coach, Angelo Hyder, the cut man, Big Rig, Dale, and Greeny giving me the water. And Greeny was like calming me down, helping me, telling me to breathe and, you know, slowing that heart rate down, giving me my water. So kind of like a F1 car pulling up in the pit stops, and everyone was just like, boom, 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 changing the tires, filling up the gas. It's special, you know. That's my country. That's where my blood comes from, man. Like, my friends and family out there, I don't get to see very often because I'm living on the other side of the country, trying to, you know, make this dream come true. And you know, when I get back to Perth, I'm trying to adjust to that 11 p.m. flight time, and I don't get to see him, you know, rolling into the fight. So pretty much straight after the fight, you know, I just tell them I ought to meet up somewhere just so I can thank them and, you know, actually thank them, because they're small moments that, you know, it's going to last for a lifetime, and I don't get to see my mob too much. So, you know, them couple of hours just to spend and have a laugh and things like that with them is the moments I cherish. And yeah, it's just, it's a very special moment.